guys, so welcome to the Teen Woodworker. So my project today is this sort of little sugar bowl holder, which you can see. I guess if you wanted to, you could just put your like keys or something in there. But it's a nice quick sort of project to do. And I did it from this, I made use of this log, which you can see here. I cut this down about 3 years ago now, and it's just sort of been drying out, I guess. It's got this massive split in it, so it's not really useful for cutting down for boards or anything. But I thought I'd make use of it for sort of bowls. It's not ideal, but because it's got all these knots in, but I make use of it anyway. And it just really came from a scrap from an end, which I used to put on the lathe. And to prepare a log like this, you'd need to split it or cut it down the middle, and then you can cut your blanks from those halves, and that'll be how you prepare a bowl for putting on the lathe. And I just want to make a point that this project is just using a faceplate. For people who don't have chucks, they can be quite an expensive cost after buying a lathe that some people don't have. And you may have seen people making bowls just doing it between centres if you don't have a chuck, and that is alright if you turn in from greenwood and you plan to go back and chuck it up and return it to finish it off. But for people who don't have chucks, you can finish the ends off or quite nicely just using a faceplate by making a sort of friction fit sort of chuck which sits over here to turn the bottom. And so obviously, as usual guys, if you have any questions, just send me a comment. Please like this video, it really helps, and subscribe to my videos if you haven't yet. Thanks.
So I start by mounting the log onto a waste block just using hot glue. This is plenty strong enough for a small project like this. And I just move the tailstock into position just to lock it into place while it's drying. Use as much glue as you can at this point. So I'm starting by roughing out the log using a roughing gouge. At this point I'm not worrying about the shape, but more just trying to knock off the edges. You could obviously knock off the edges by using a saw to start with before it's mounted, but in my opinion there wasn't too much wood to remove, so I didn't worry about it. After knocking off the edges, I could then again use the roughing gouge to create the shape of my bowl. Now that I've got the outside shape of my bowl, I can begin to worry about the inside. So I start by just using like a beading tool just to flatten off the front. This is because it's not exactly flat on the front, and it's just a bit safer and easier just to use a beading tool. I'm now using a spindle gouge to take out the bulk of the material on the inside. When I turn the lathe off, I find that the rim is still not flush, so I'm just using the beading tool again just to make sure that the rim is even all over. So I'm now using a round nose scraper as I get deeper into the bowl. I just find this a little bit safer, although it doesn't give as good a cut as a spindle gouge. So I've now slowed down the lathe to its slowest setting, and I'm using the sandpaper just to smooth out the inside. I also do a little bit of the outside edge, but I can do that later if I haven't completely finished. So now that the inside of the bowl is sanded to about 320 grit, I'm using a finishing oil to finish up the inside of the bowl. I also do some of the outside edge of the bowl as well. You need to be careful when using finish for like sugar bowls and things, and make sure it's a salad bowl finish or mineral oil. You really don't want toxic chemicals in your sugar that you're going to be eating. So now with the inside of the bowl finished, I'm just prying it off the lathe, and this is because it's hot glue and it doesn't hold that securely. You may need to also use chisels just to persuade it. I did this instead of parting it off because it's just a little bit safer. So using the waste block again, I've turned it down so that it's a friction fit against the inside of the bowl. You could also use some hot glue, which will help it to secure a bit more. Make sure the glue sort of almost dry before you apply it onto the bowl so it doesn't stick to the inside. I'm now using a round nose scraper again just to sort of flatten up the bottom and just to begin hollowing out just the inside of the bottom. This is so it stands flat when it's on the surface. So I've set the lathe back to its lowest speed for sanding now. And you can see I also created a little lip on the bottom, which just creates a sort of decorative feature. Once I finish sanding, I can apply the finish. So I'm just finishing up the bottom of the bowl now, using the same finish as I used for the inside. Because this is an oil-based finish I'm using, it doesn't matter where the finish overlaps from the previous time. Obviously, if you were using a sort of film creating finish, like a lacquer, you're going to need to be more careful about how you finish the bottom, and you'll need to sand it over later using a very fine grit. Once I've done this and the finish is dry, the bowl is finished. So thanks for watching the Teen Woodworker, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Once again, remember to subscribe, like and comment, and I'll see you again soon, guys. Bye bye.